Would you share your job to avoid being laid off? Editor's note: a version of this story appeared in CNN's Work Transformed newsletter. To get it in your inbox, sign up for free here. The job losses keep on coming. More than 40 million Americans have filed for first-time unemployment benefits since the coronavirus pandemic shut the economy down in March. The bad news is the losses likely aren't over. Even as businesses continue to reopen, there will be many employers that won't be able to maintain the same staffing levels. One way to stem the losses could be job sharing, which means employers would reduce workers' hours instead of instituting layoffs or furloughs, explains Jason Ward, an associate economist at the nonprofit, Nonpartisan Rand Corporation for CNN Business Perspectives. Here's how Ward explains it could work. Say an employer has two full-time workers making $2,000 a week, but needs to reduce payroll by $2,000 a week. Instead of letting one of the employees go, they both become part-time. Each worker would then earn $1,000 a week and would work 20 hours. There is an obvious disadvantage to this arrangement: less work means less pay. And many workers might be more willing to have their hours and pay reduced if they know the alternative is losing their job, giving the employer an upper hand, Ward writes. He argues that continuous employment, even at reduced hours, is often preferred over being furloughed or laid off. Job sharing could actually prove to be an attractive option to some working parents who have lost their childcare due to the many schools, daycares, and camps that have closed. For employers considering using this option, Ward said the key is honesty and openness. Read more about job sharing here. Unemployment rate: where does your state rank? Here's a title no state wants to hold: highest unemployment rate. Unemployment rates in 43 states set record highs last month, according to CNN's Tommy Lubbe. And none are left unscathed. Rates increased in every state in the District of Columbia. But where are workers getting hit the most? Nevada. The closing of the state's casino and tourism industries brought widespread job losses and an unemployment rate of 28.2% in April. It was 6.9% in March and 3.6% in February. Michigan had the second highest unemployment rate at 22.7%, with major job losses in accommodation and food services. Hawaii, another state that's heavily reliant on travel and tourism, was just behind it with a rate of 22.3%. Click here to read why the numbers could actually be even worse. How these workers are adapting to pandemic life: how does a nail salon keep bringing in cash during a pandemic that has led to mass closures and will require social distancing for the foreseeable future? What about tattoo artists or other professionals that require close physical contact? They get creative. CNN's Shannon Liao talked with a nail salon owner in New Jersey who started selling nail care products and press-on nails for people to use at home. And she's been able to expand beyond the Garden State. She now has customers in Florida, North Carolina, and Ohio. Read the full story on how a bartender, tattoo artist, and hair salon owner are adapting to keep revenue coming in. Feeling stuck in a rut? This can help. If you feel like you've hit a wall with this whole working from home situation, you aren't alone. You could be drained from all the extra hours you've been working because work-life balance isn't really possible these days. Maybe it's that weird feeling of being completely overwhelmed but bored at the same time. And it's hard to stay motivated when events we used to look forward to, like seeing friends and co-workers or going on that long-planned vacation, can't happen for a while. Talk about feeling stuck in a rut. The good news is that small changes can jumpstart your productivity. Find your power hour. We all have times of the day when we are more productive. Identify yours and go all in. Plowing through a lot of work can help you get revved up and motivated. Make some small upgrades. Don't underestimate the power of sprucing up your workspace. Try bringing in some fresh flowers, framed pictures, or any items that carry a positive memory. Upgrading your technology to make your workflow more seamless and uninterrupted can also help with productivity. And speaking of upgrades, it might be time to change out of your sweats. Yes, I've been living in workout pants for almost 3 months now, but maybe it's time we part ways at least a few days a week. I am not talking about dressing like you would for work, although some experts do suggest this, but just try to take it up a notch. Set new goals. Creating goals can help us stay focused and motivated. But the world has changed a lot since the start of the year, and it might be time to refocus. Traveling the world to bring in new international customers isn't in the cards at the moment. So maybe this year is more about finding new products or taking the lead on a project to help build your management skills. Click here to get more tips on getting unstuck when working from home. Getting your morning routine right. There's nothing worse than waking up feeling stressed. But it's time to nip that in the bud, so you don't carry it into the entire workday. So here's the plan: start your day with this 5-minute yoga routine. Quick yoga sessions can help improve your energy levels and brain function, according to Stephanie Manser, a certified yoga instructor. She created this yoga routine to help you loosen up your body, to begin the day feeling calm and positive. And here's the best part: most of the moves can be done from your bed. Coffee break. Your summer plans probably aren't shaping up the way you envisioned. Many summer camps have been cancelled. Trips to crowded amusement parks, pools and museums are restricted, and other vacation destinations are likely going to be much more limited. But that doesn't mean you can't have any fun this summer. In fact, CNN's Keisha Hedder crowdsourced 100 fun things to do this summer. I personally am a big fan of 21 to 23. But that's mostly because I've been embracing my inner chef these days. Read the full list here. Click subscribe to receive the latest news.